everybody here. As you will know, we are not exactly on number 99 this time. And the reason because of it is because I, the idiot that I am, forgot to start the recording when I started this battle originally. So it kind of got rid of all the hypeness that I had with all that was happening. I actually didn't get through the battle until I noticed that I didn't start yet. Oh no. He started with both of them. No. He only started with one last time. Oh man. Crap. Maybe we can get lucky. Maybe I'll get lucky. I know Starmie's faster, but maybe we'll get lucky. Maybe we'll get lucky. No, we won't. Dang it! He started off with his Latias flaking last time, which made it easier for me. But then he started off with both. Oh, and a calm mind. That. The only good thing coming out of this is that Starmie can attack first, each time. That's the only good thing that comes out of this. Because they're freaking powerhouses. Come on! Whoever gets hit by it, survive! Survive! The boy I'm showing why it's beast. So yeah, Latios down. I originally, during the first battle I did against this guy, which, again, did record, I originally could have beat him without using items, but this one's becoming so close that I might actually have to. Fight. I didn't use items throughout the entire mount battle, and I want to keep it that way. Also, in the first one, I actually froze Latios with an ice beam. Too bad I didn't get it on camera. It sucks so bad! And Slaking will take out Starmie this time, because last time it got hit by an Intimidate, and Starmie survived. Actually, we're gonna predict the Salamence switch. Cause he does have one. Come on, quick! Switch the Salamence! Switch the Salamence! Come on! You know you want to! Oh yeah! Victory is mine! Eat my beam! Now eat my beam! Predicting switches all day, guys. All day. Switching them. Predicting! Predicting! Go for the earthquake! Damage your own self! Woo! Yes, Metagross is weak to ground, so that's gonna make it easier for me. That's how we do it. Yeah, no. I know his last Pokemon. His last Pokemon is Dusclops. We pretty much won, guys. It's pretty much over right now. So there you go, guys. That's the end of the video. I'm just... We can't lose at this point. Every other Pokemon of mine has Protect or Detect and cannot be killed by Slaking. I mean, it's not possible. We cannot lose. When recording this, it was a real drag because sometimes the computer would go into sleep mode. And apparently, I think it's Ice Beam. It's gotta be Ice Beam. Or Protect. You can also be Protect. Yep. But then again, he already attacked! Blinking's the only one left. And with his truant, he can't fight back pretty much. Vaporeon, Hydro Pump! Jolteon, use your Thunderbolt! Maximum power! Alright, the hypeness wasn't gone entirely. It's still here. And Jolteon reached level 71. There you go, guys! Mount Battle's final member, Battleist. Magnificent! So guys, magnificent, truly magnificent. You being so young may not understand how I can be so happy about losing. Well, I'm delighted, even ecstatic, that someone so young as you could defeat me. Congratulations, here are your Poke Coupons for clearing Area 10. Oh my, you did it! You cleared Mount Battle entirely without changing your Pokemon once! Your talent is incredible! Without thoroughly knowing and trusting your Pokemon, this feat would have been seemingly impossible. For your record-setting Pokemon, let me give you these mementos of your training here at Mount Battle. They are exclusive ribbons for commemorating their 100 win streak at Mount Battle. You can take it in pride. So yes, if you battle all 100 trainers in a row without changing your Pokemon once, they will all get this medal. And if you do it, he will also give you one of three Pokemon. Chikorita, Cyndaquil, or Totodile. Each of them know four moves. Can't remember what they are at the top of my head, but one move they all share in common are their Elemental Beam Cannon. Frenzy Plant, Blast Burn, and Hydro Cannon. I already decided that I was going to take the Pokemon that will be my choice when I play Pokemon Coliseum in the future, which I'll be picking Totodile. Why? Because I like Totodile. I want you to never forget the way you feel now. I want you to keep battling on with that feeling in your heart. And one day, I want you to return and defeat me again. I'll be expecting you. And that's it. Thank you very much, guys. That was the end of my walkthrough. I enjoyed making this with all my heart. I hope you enjoy, and stay tuned for the credits I will be making to just collapse. What's the word? Basically celebrate my first walkthrough I did in a long time and got everything to work the way it needed to be. Until then, I'm Walkthrough Buddy, signing out. See you guys on the next Walkthrough Buddy Walkthrough. Till then.